make your eyelids automatic. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey, could count on my power and look at my dogs. So, way back then, could claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how did you get up? I done got rich, then went broke, then got rich again, just a little hiccup. I done been ballin' this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. How did the lady go miss? How she with magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the fucks and we caught a little rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked it.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her? How I did it? Yeah. Spend the whole half. Had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex. I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Before I went live, they ain't know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Need a light here just to catch my buzz. Need right here just to catch my cup. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, they ain't never seen too much. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with some cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said, what's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like,
let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her? How I did it? Yeah. Spend the whole half. Had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex. I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different. So I ask, can I?
Yo,
yeah.
Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19, huh? I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chess coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense to really get it. I'm ready, get into the chicken, that jerky finger licky chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my sauce. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey yo, Nike check. T-shirt check. Sneakers check. Socks check. Hoodie check. Shorts check. Nike check. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. The shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist, going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. Going up sky high while I'm rocking Air Force. And she just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. She was rocking stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off-whites. Okay, now wait, wait, wait. Gotta get the bag and racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Got a new press, those and the J's in the way. Got a new wrist watch, ready, don't take time. Might pull up on a hop if it's talking too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist, going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo, Nike check.
Thank you. The tundra may not quite be frozen, but it's getting there as we work our way through December. The radar today, however, is clear at Lambeau Field in Green Bay. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. It's the final 3 weeks of the season, still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Carry for Christian McCaffrey, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run, run CMC as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
A gain of five brings up.
If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
On third down, Bridgewater. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Bridgewater going to give this to McCaffrey. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. From the gun, Bridgewater. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them, and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be, but early in this one, advantage defense.
Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup. Aaron Jones.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
From just shy of midfield, Rodgers. Looking for Funchess, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple.
Yeah, we dominate today.
Thought he had the pick. Flag comes in for PI, so cancel it out.
Interference. Oh, a killer for them. Thought they had a nice play. Instead, they'll be marching off yardage against them.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Jeremy Chin there defensively.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard. One. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
Good. We're
just enough to get the first down there with a one-yard pickup.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They run with Adrian Peterson, the second active leading rusher in the NFL. And boy, showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards. It's a pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, but pound the rock.
And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. We're scoreless after one. First and goal from the 6. Now Jones. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
The tackle.
Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's 2nd and goal. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones. Touchdown number 15 on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Crosby connects on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, it does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
On 2nd down, McCaffrey. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet,
sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run with McCaffrey. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
He was brought down by
Brandon. 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 11 yards there, first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. Patrick Onwuasor up to make the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. There's Bridgewater. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. So the screen good for only 2. Now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
And that is incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game, because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
From the 22, here's 2nd and 8. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line.
Tackled at the 25-yard line. That's the
2 minutes on the clock. Second quarter. 7-0 ball game. You that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. He's going to go deep for Funchess. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Line of scrimmage.
Kenny Clark came into the league as one of the youngest players ever to be drafted. He's now one of the unsung leaders of this Packers defense. Went to the Pro Bowl for the first time after the 2019 season.
Now a throw here on second down, and that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
13 yards.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. That's another gain of 15 on back-to-back plays.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
That's a tough spot for a running back coming out of the backfield because you know he's got to look for the football. Knowing full well, he's got a man coming his way, full steam, and he broke that one up.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Green Bay up to the task there in coverage and forcing a fourth down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Now we're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play because if you think about trying to fool.
That's caught inside the 20. And he's going to get this deep on the Carolina side of the field. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Jay Sternberger, there. That'll bring up second down.
It leads to second and 10.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. A 33-yarder from the left hash. And the 13-year man puts it through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
Green to bring it back. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. Taking it about the 1. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Touchdown, The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. They follow up the first down one-yard run with a minimal gain of two. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lot behind it. Wow.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their defense just came up with a stop right out of the locker room, and now can the offense take advantage?
Yeah, we don't want to turn this into something that it's not. It's only a one-score game, so it's not exactly a crucial possession. But at the same time, they'd like to get things started and at least come away with 3 points.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
A gain of 15.
Those are the types of runs they told us they want to see more of. Look, they'd love the 60 to 70 yard runs, but those 10 to 20 yarders, they can help you win a ball game.
And that means everyone's invested, because you know the big guys up front, that's what they do. They try and move people. But when you get your perimeter guys involved downfield, that means that they care about the running game, and they know it helps their team.
3 yards the gain there, second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Bridgewater from the gun on third down. And the throw there going to be incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Second and nine now from the 21. To throw is Rodgers. Incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Devontae Adams, his intended receiver, and it's third down.
I know we spent a lot of time talking about how the defensive backs read routes and make plays on the football. How about a good linebacker feeling the route, seeing the quarterback, jumps the play, and knocks it away. Really well done.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Shotgun now for Rodgers. It's caught. Jones. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. Nowhere to go that time.
Aaron Jones.
He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
He's tackled at the 40-yard line.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
Again, it's Jones. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. A gain of two there on the heels of a one-yard pickup on first.
Brings up third and seven.
Rodgers to throw on third down. They'll roll him out right. Hard throw, incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Here's J.K. Scott now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Bridgewater going to lead the Panthers up here, first and 10 at the 20. Trying to get the running game going with McCaffrey. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23.
McCaffrey, the ball carrier.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Now second and seven from the 23. Bridgewater. Blitz coming and down he goes. Dean Lowry in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
First defensive back taken in this year's draft, Darnell Savage there to knock that one away. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. This is taken to the 18. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's out of bounds, but not before a big pickup that time on what's going to wind up being the final play of the third quarter. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. They'll run it with Jones. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
From the 39, Rodgers. That's complete to the former Aggie Jay Sternberger. Touchdown, Packers! Jay Sternberger, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. From the 25, here's second and six. Bridgewater. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. 24-yard gain on the fourth quarter. Every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You can have the first one for the second one to even matter.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A gain of 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 36. Bridgewater now. Oh, hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. The ball carrier.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle, because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
Here's Bridgewater. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And that will be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Bridgewater. And no, it's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that, because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense.
But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to four-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll go again to Jones. And for a second straight play, just nowhere to go thanks to this Carolina defense. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this will pin him back deep. That's going to kick out of bounds right at about the 7-yard line. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the intended target. And now it's second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. A second down completion got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3. Throwing, Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's 4th down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Bridgewater to throw for it on 4. Completes it to Samuel. And some room to maneuver. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a 1st down.
Carolina.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. They'll throw again, Bridgewater. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
So line of scrimmage, still at 39 on 2nd and 10. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 34. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build
on. Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Give them 14 on that one, and a first down. A first down throw for Bridgewater. Flushed out right. Oh, and Bridgewater intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line.
The Packers take over first and 10 at the 20-yard line.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. So it's all over. A Green Bay victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last point of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for Green Bay, it's a 10th win of the year now as they move to 10-4. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the